Cause it's all about money, ain't a damn thing funny. Cause it's all about money, ain't a damn thing funny.
1 Timothy 5:8, it says, if any provide not for his own, especially for those of his own house, he has denied the faith and is worse than an infidel.
Damn thing funny, cause it's all about money, cause it's all about money.
There's 16 texts that mention the word that describe the content of the holy tithe. And they're always only food from inside Israel. If there's 16 out of 16 verses that describe the contents of the tithe that way, then that must be the contents of the tithe. What about Abraham's tithe? Well, in the first place, the Bible doesn't tell us why Abraham tithed. In the second place, it is clear that which he did tithe was from pagan property. And none of that would have ever been allowed into the temple as a holy tithe. Yes, he tithed, but why did he tithe? And it wasn't a holy tithe. It was just something. I'm convinced he was obeying the law of the land. And I'm not making that up. In those days, if you had spoils of war, you were required to look by the law of the land to give it to your local king priest. God owns the cattle on a thousand hills and everything is his. Well, that was true in the Old Testament, but even then, even though that was part of the Old Testament and that was true in the Old Testament, the tithe could still only come from God's holy land. See, the idea was that the land of Canaan was God's holy land, and the tithe had to come off of what was already holy. And to go further, it had to come off of what God increased. That's why it could only be food. You can plant something and have a cow, but you can't reproduce them. They have to reproduce under God's blessings, right? Yeah. Therefore, the increase that was tithed had to be something that God increased and not man. That way man could never say, God, you owe me something because I gave you a tithe off of something I made.
Yeah.
Malachi was written 1,000 years after Leviticus 27 and Numbers 18. Where the tithe was first defined as food. And in Malachi 3:10, the verse everybody quotes, bring you all the tithe to the storehouse if they need food or meat or
money.
You know? And then, right. It's still only food.
I'm not going to be going to heaven and be broke when I get there.
Bring you all the tithe that there may be meat in my storehouse. Meat, meat, yeah.
Right.
So it's still only food. In the verse they quote. And then they'll turn around and say, oh, that means the first fruits of your income. Well, in the first place, Malachi is only addressed to Israel under the Old Covenant, and we are New Covenant Christians. In the second place, Malachi is really, really specifically addressed to dishonest priesthood and stealing.
Yeah.
You read chapter 1, verse 6, chapter 2, verse 1, God has already cursed the priest 4 times before he gets to Malachi 3. Why would he be cursing the priest and all of a sudden feel sorry for the priest?
Give me control of a nation's currency, and I care not who makes its laws.
With the money that you print, you can buy anybody in the world. There's nobody who can resist whatever funds you want to give them.
See, it makes no sense.
Right.
Bring ye all the tithes in the storehouse and tell them the priest to bring the tithes back to the storehouse, which they had taken out of it. In Nehemiah 13:5. When he says, test me in this, he's not saying, you keep the tithe, you tithe, and I will bless you, and it's all right to go ahead and murder and steal and commit adultery. You can break those laws, but as long as you tithe, you're testing me in the tithe, and I'm going to bless you. That's hogwash.
Yeah.
God don't, that's not the Old Testament concept of the law. 1 Timothy 5:8, it says, if any provide not for his own, especially for those of his own house, he has denied the faith and is worse than an infidel.